Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Pastor Johnson Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription this amazing and wonderful morning. I'm excited as always to have this great opportunity to minister into our lives, and I know that in the Word of God there is power, there is anointing, there's revelation, there is glory and power. So I pray this morning that the Lord will minister to us greatly wherever you are, that the Lord will bless your life. Shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we thank you and we lift you this moment. We are praying that you take control. You move in our lives than ever before for the glory of your name. I pray that anybody who shall encounter this word, their lives will never ever be the same again for the glory and honor of your name. This we pray, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I want to talk about a subject, the Lord is present. The Lord is present. I read the Bible in the book of Matthew chapter number 28. I'm reading verse number 20, Matthew 28 and verse number 20 from the Good News Translation. The Bible says, "And teach them to obey everything I have commanded you, and I'll be with you always to the end of the age." Now, God promises that he will be with us to the end of the age. And I'm talking about the presence of God in our lives. Now, I want you to know, child of God, that when the blessings come from God, when the environment continues to appreciate what God wants to do through us, we must then know that if God is with you, you're going to experience greatness and goodness. Now, I speak right into your spirit that it's important for you to know, when God is with us, we become undefeatable duo or people that operate in partnership with God. Then it's very obvious that failure will not be our portion. There are some things we have gotten in life, not because we worked hard, not because we were the smartest, not because we have everything we required. They simply occurred because there was the presence of God. There was the favor of God in your life. I want you to know, therefore, that when we partner with God in this endeavor for him to help us achieve or become the destiny that he's intended, we must provide an avenue for God to thrive. An avenue for God to show his presence. An avenue to show his power, ability, grace, and glory. So when you partner with God in your life and God is therefore present, I can decree and declare without any shadow of contradiction that when you're with God, you are more than a conqueror. Praise the name of the Lord. That means it calls upon us to provide a presence, to provide an environment for God to show up in our lives, to create an environment for God to come and dwell. Now listen, when Jesus was on his way, Zacchaeus, the man who was a tax collector, realizes that Jesus was going to pass through that way, but he was a short man. So Zacchaeus actually climbed on top of a sycamore tree, and were on just besides the way that Jesus was going to follow. Now, when Jesus comes to this place, he says, "Zacchaeus, come down. Today I'm going to dine with you." Praise the name of the Lord. There is nothing as important or significant for you to open up your heart for God to come and dwell in your life. Now, when God dwells in a man, when God dwells in a place, when God dwells in a nation, when God dwells in the business of a man, I can tell you the favor that exists in your life will be beauty to behold. Look at Obed-Edom, for instance. When the Ark of the Covenant was taken to Obed-Edom's place, the Bible tells us he prospered. And everybody heard about the prosperity of Obed-Edom keeping the Ark of the Covenant. The Bible asks us a question. Don't you know you are the temple of God, of the Holy Spirit? You are the place where God resides. Now, when God is in your life, when God is in your environment, everything complies to the will of God. Everything will react to the very basic nature of God in your life. And I came to speak to us this morning because I believe that the Lord is present. And when God is present in your life, I can declare that you shall win your battles. You shall be encouraged. You shall be strengthened. The Lord will beautify you with the glory from heaven. You will become an attraction. Praise the name of the Lord. And so I came to speak right into your spirit. And I pray that God opens your eyes of understanding to pursue that which God intends for you. Let me put it this way. The Bible tells us the more the people accepted to follow the cloud in the day and the pillar of fire in the night, talking about the children of Israel, God granted them victory over their enemies. Where he required to provide safe passage, he did. Where he came down to fight for his people, he did. When he came to a place where he was going to favor them, stand with them, then he did. So allowing God to thrive in your life, allowing God to be available in your life, because you have generally put up the platform for God to operate, I can tell you this morning, the Lord will make you to be lifted in such a way that you never thought yourself. Have you also not read from scripture that every creature, every creation is waiting for the manifestation of the children of God? Have you not read that in the scripture? And so when we are with God, the Bible tells us we are more than conquerors. It is him that worketh in us both to will and to do for his good pleasure. Have you understood therefore what I'm saying? That provide an avenue for God to dwell in you. Now, when God dwells in you, I can guarantee you that your life will be a success in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. When we network with God, then our net worth is about God's presence in your life. That is what I desire. Now, let me ask this fundamental question. How do people perceive you? Do they perceive you as a person who is blessed, worthy of the calling of God? Do they perceive you as a person who carries God? Do they even pursue or do they even know you as a person who understands what God is doing? Praise the name of the Lord. You've got to be in tandem with the Spirit of God. You have to make him make an abode in your spirit, and your life will never ever be the same again. I pray that the Spirit of God will give you revelation power to understand what it is there is for you to allow God to come and dine with you like he did in Zacchaeus' time. God is willing. Are you willing? God is ready. Are you ready? And I pray this morning in Jesus' name as we come to a close that God Almighty open the eyes of your understanding, that you can know for sure what is it that God desires to do in our lives, that we can move in the dimension of God, that we can move in the glorious nature of God in the name of Jesus, the good Lord. Therefore, bless you, be with you, and the Lord lift you in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you. Thank you for your word. I pray that you minister to us through your spirit, O God, that we can understand you. And that when you're present, things will change for the better. I thank you and I bless you this morning in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. The good Lord therefore bless you. This has been your host, Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription, your daily morning dose of the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Shalom. The good Lord be with you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.